Hello and good day. You're welcome to the April 22nd edition of the Open Heavens Daily Devotional. The Open Heavens Daily Devotional is written by our Father and the Lord, Pastor Enoch Adeboye. Our topic for today is Peculiar Generation. Our memory verse is taken from 1 John 3 and verse 1. Behold, what manner of love hath the Father bestowed upon us, that we should be called the sons of God. Therefore, the world knoweth us not, because it knew him not. I'll take it again. Behold, what manner of love the Father hath bestowed upon us, that we should be called the sons of God. Therefore, the world knoweth us not, because it knew him not. We're reading 1 Peter 2, verse 9 to 10. But you are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, his own special people, that you may proclaim the praises of him who called you out of darkness into his marvelous light, who were once not a people, but are now the people of God, who had not obtained mercy, but now have obtained mercy. Hallelujah. Amen. In 1 John 3 verse 2, John the Beloved could not help pondering on how privileged we are as believers to be called children of God. Apostle Peter explained the glorious implication of this in 1 Peter 2 verse 9 to 10. But ye are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, an holy nation, a peculiar people, that ye should show forth the praises of him who hath called you out of darkness into his marvelous light, which in time past were not a people, but are now the people of God, who had not obtained mercy, but now have obtained mercy. Hallelujah, glory to God. This is just the miracle of salvation. And it's such an awesome, awesome, awesome story that we who were people who were abandoned, who were destitute and destined to die and perish in our sins, God sent his son to die so that through his blood we can be ransomed, so that through the blood of Jesus we can be inheritances. We can be inheritors of the promise that is in God, and we can inherit that through Christ. Now, we are not only heirs of God, we are joint heirs with Christ. How amazing. We are not only heirs of God, we are joint heirs with Christ. In other words, you and I have the inheritance of Christ. We can inherit in God. We can be called the children of God because of the sacrifice that Jesus Christ has made for us. This is the best thing that can happen to somebody. This is the greatest testimony. This is the greatest miracle that has ever happened on the history of planet Earth, that Jesus saves. And Jesus has given you and I the boldness to call God Abba Father. Hallelujah. As believers, we are a peculiar generation. That is a generation of people who have given themselves to seeking God. Psalm 24 verse 1 to 6. When something is described as peculiar, another synonym for peculiar can be unique, different, set apart. We are people who don't live like the world. We are people called out from the world to live a life according to our Father and the Lord that is given to seeking God. In other words, the full essence of our life is to seek God. Everything we do involves seeking God. Whether we sleep or eat or go to work, we seek God all the same. Hallelujah. A peculiar generation refers to those who have obtained mercy and thus have become solution providers and barrier breakers. Peculiar people have obtained mercy. Amen. They are unstoppable. Nothing can stand in their way because they are God's children. They call God Abba Father. Can you imagine if you have the Almighty Creator of the universe at your side? Nothing can stand in the way of people who are peculiar, called and set apart for righteousness. Amen. Joseph belonged to this kind of generation He would not compromise godliness and perfect loyalty to God and man, as we see in Genesis 39:7-9. Like we said earlier, peculiar people are different. They are people who have decided to live their lives to honor God. Like the example of Joseph, even when Potiphar's wife was tempting him with all the glory, he refused to stand. He refused to stand there and partake of that iniquity. He ran away because he knows that he couldn't, he can't do something like that. Like a statement I used to hear always is that others may, but you can't. That is the mantra of peculiar people. Others may, but you can't, because you are different, because you are bought with a price, and that price is the precious blood of Jesus that was shed on Calvary. The generation of solution providers like Daniel, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego was also a peculiar one. Daniel 2:17-19. If you belong to this generation, you must be ready to seek the Lord even in the midst of ungodly people. 2 Corinthians 6:17-18. Daniel and his friends are an example of wonderful of people who were peculiar. The Bible says they said they must bow down to the king, and they were about to be burnt in fire, and these people refused. They said, we will not worship any other god, even if God doesn't save them. They were ready to burn in the fire, and guess what happened when they threw them in the fire? The fourth man in the fire stood with them, Jesus Christ. And like people always say, the fire became like air conditioning for them. That is what happens when you decide to stand for God and you decide to be peculiar. Today we see people who treat the Bible as outdated literature. They do not see homosexuality, witchcraft, and sorcery as ungodly. Some of these people even make light of Christ's teachings. Beloved, if you belong to the peculiar generation, you must dissociate yourself from such people. As we know in our times, so many people are putting down the work of Christ, insulting the very wonderful sacrifice that Jesus made for us. We must separate ourselves from these people, because we are going to different places. We know what God has promised for us. Sometimes though, you may experience marginalization. The good thing is that members of the peculiar generation who remain untarred are undeterred, are always victorious in the end. Hallelujah. This is because God already assures them of victory, as we see in Numbers 23:23. The Bible says, many are the afflictions of the righteous, but the Lord delivers them from them all. Beloved, if you are facing persecution because you are a Christian, rejoice. The Bible says, rejoice, because if you suffer with him, you will also be glorified with him. I encourage you and I to hold fast and stand firm with our faith as being peculiar people, so that God will be glorified in us, in Jesus' name. I encourage you to be a member of this peculiar generation of people by seeking God actively at a time like this, when it is appearing unpopular to live by the principles of the over 2,000 year old scripture. May God bless you as you do so today, in the mighty name of Jesus. Beloved, we are set apart. Beloved, we are different. And we will stand for Jesus. Like that hymn says, oh my comrades, see the signal waving in the sky. By the grace of Jesus, we will stand. And we will stand firm until eternity. Prayer point. Father, please accept me into the generation of peculiar people that show forth your praise. In Jesus' name, amen. Thank you. And I look forward to seeing you tomorrow.